In today's video, we are going to see chapter number 5, Java Applet and Graphics. In this, we are going to see the Graphics Environment class. My name is Professor Pokharkar MS, HOD, Computer Engineering Department, Samartha Polytechnic, Bele. Now, Graphics Environment class. This class describes collection of graphics device objects and font objects available to Java on particular platform. Now, how to create the object of graphics environment class? So graphics environment class don't have any constructor or abstract class to create its object, but there is a one method that will create the object of graphics environment class. Let us see. The method is get local graphics environment. The method is get local graphics environment. This method will convert or return the object of graphics environment class. Now this method is belonging to the same class, that is graphics environment class, and this method is static. When the method is static, it is accessible using the class name. Okay, so using this object we can return the local graphics environment. Okay, and with the help of this graphics environment, as we discuss, we can return the all the fonts objects and all the font families present into the object. Now let us see the methods of graphics environment class. Now method are the get available font family names. This is a method of graphics environment class. Now this method return the array containing the name of all font families present in graphics environment object, which is usually on the local machine. Okay, so whatever the font family present on the local machine, all the names of font families will be written by this method, and all names means no more than one value, so that it returns the array. So let us see the syntax. The syntax is like this: public abstract string array get available font family names. So return type is a string, so that it returns the array of all font families. Okay, now we'll see the example at the end of this presentation. Now let us understand the syntax. Okay, now next method, get all fonts. Get all fonts, this is the method, get all fonts. Now this method will return the array containing the object of all fonts present on local machine. Okay, now this method is also returning the array, but it return the array of font object. So that the syntax, if we see the syntax, having the font array get all fonts. Okay, return the array of font objects. Now we have to see now the example of the graphics environment object. Now we are going to see the example which will return the names of all font family which are present on the local machine. Now here we have imported the applet package because we are extending the applet class, and we have imported AWT package because we are using the graphics class as well as graphics environment class. Now here public void paint, the parameter is graphics G. Okay, now here graphics environment G, this object is possible by using the method get local graphics environment. Graphics environment dot get local graphics environment, this object, this method will return the graphics environment object. Now this object GE will contain the all font family names as well as all font objects. Now we can return the all font family names by using the method that is a get available font family names. Okay, names means plurals, it return the more than one value, and these names are stored into the array string message array. In this array all the font family names are present. Now here when name variable is declared which contain the blank string. Now here for loop int I equal to 0, I less than message dot length I plus plus. Now here name is equal to name plus message of I plus here blank empty string. Okay, now here what is happening in this statement? This statement is at concatenating all the message array values to the name string. Okay, now when we are joining all the strings together into the single variable, we can display the string on applet using drawstring method. This contain the array. We cannot use array in drawstring method. So that what we have done using this for loop, we have retrieved the all the array values and concatenated with the this name string. Okay, we have joined all the array values into the single string. Okay, now this string we can display on the applet by using drawstring method, and when we run this program, we are getting the names of all font families on the applet screen. Now let us run the program. I already run this program. We'll show you once again the execution. Now compile the program. Now program is compiled. Now for execution of this program, we should include this applet code into the program. Okay, applet code environment demo.class width and height we have to specify. We have to include this in our program. Now here applet viewer in environment demo.java. Our program are executed. Now it will display the names of all font families on the applet. Okay, so this is the output will be displayed by the get available font family names. Okay, so this is the last topic from the chapter number 5. Our chapter number 5 is completed. Okay, let us stop.